In my last video, I introduced Taskmaster AI. We covered the basics, but I quickly realized that was only scratching the surface. I've been using this method for my own projects since then, and to manage a real-world, long-term project, I needed more. I needed better organization, ways to handle changing requirements, and more powerful research tools. So I dove deeper into the Taskmaster methodology, and what I found was a complete advanced system for managing the entire development lifecycle. Today I'm sharing that advanced workflow with you. We have a lot to cover, so let's get started. Before we dive in, I want to re-emphasize the most important principle of Taskmaster, especially when working on AI assistant like Claude. You do not need to memorize any of the commands I'm about to show you. The entire point of this methodology is to use natural language. Instead of remembering the exact syntax for a command, you just describe what you want. You don't need to type taskmaster update --from5--prompt, etc. You just type I need to update all tasks from ID5 onward because we are switching from REST to GraphQL. Claude understands the full taskmaster toolset and will execute the correct commands or use the correct MCP tools for you. This works because the taskmaster documentation is imported into a root claude.md file, giving the AI the context it needs to operate the tools. What you do need to understand is what's possible. You need to know the strategies and the workflows. This guide is about showing you what's possible so you know what to ask for. In the first video, we parsed one PRD, but projects are never finished. What happens when you have a new feature request? You have two simple options. For a small single feature, you can just add it as a new task. You can say, please add a new task to support dark mode, and Claude will run taskmaster at task --prompt at dark mode support --research. But for a major new feature, like a whole new admin section, you should write a new separate PRD for it. Then you can parse this new PRD and append it to your existing task list. Taskmaster parse PRD.taskmaster/docs/admin-feature.prd --append. This adds the new tasks at the end without touching your completed work. It's a clean way to add large chunks of work to a living project. This append method is good, but as your project grows, your main task list will become huge, filled with hundreds of done tasks. This gets hard to manage. The recommended solution for this is tags. Tags are the single most powerful feature for long-term organization. A tag is a completely separate task list in an isolated context. You can have tags for features, for sprints, for releases, or for different team members. This lets you keep your completed work organized and archived, while you work on new features in a clean, fresh task list. The best way to use tags is to map them to your Git branches. Let's say you're on the main branch. You can have a master tag for your main tasks. Now you need to build a new authentication feature. First, you create a new Git branch, git checkout -b feature auth. Now you can tell Taskmaster to create a new tag from that branch name, taskmaster add tag --from branch. This creates a new empty tag named feature auth. Now you just switch to it, taskmaster use tag feature auth. And that's it. You are now in a clean, isolated workspace. You can parse your auth prd.md here, and all your tasks for authentication will live inside this feature auth tag. They won't clutter your master tag. When you are done, you can merge your branch and switch back to your master tag, git checkout main taskmaster use tag master. Taskmaster even remembers which tag belongs to which branch in a file called .taskmaster/state.json. This workflow is a game changer. It keeps your project perfectly organized. You can list all your tags, copy tasks between them, or move tasks to a dedicated archive tag. And this system scales. If your main tasks.json file itself becomes massive over time, you can manually archive the entire file. Just rename your taskmaster tasks.json file to something like tasks-archive-2024.json. Taskmaster won't automatically create a new one. You'll have to either clear it out manually, or more commonly, just parse a new PRD, which will generate a fresh tasks.json file for you. For daily cleanup, you also have full control. You can ask Claude to delete individual tasks or even delete an entire tag and all the tasks inside it. This is perfect for cleaning up old feature branch tags after you've merged your code. It's the true solution for long-term project management. In the first video, we used dash dash research flag, but I want to talk about why it is so important and how to use it correctly. When you ask Claude a question, it uses its internal knowledge. Even if your model was trained last month, it has no way of knowing about a new library, a critical security patch, or new documentation that was released last week. But when you use dash dash research, Taskmaster uses a different model, usually Perplexity's Sonar Pro, that actively searches the internet in real time. This means it finds the latest documentation, the current best practices, and any recent security warning. The difference is huge. Without research, you might get a task suggesting use state and use effect for data fetching. With research, the AI finds the latest React docs and suggests using the new use hook with a promise or even a server component, which is the current best practice. This is how you avoid outdated code and build with modern secure patterns. I recommend using dash dash research for deinitial parseprd, any analyze complexity command, when expanding any complex task, when adding task for a new technology you haven't used before. Now for the most critical pro tip. For the research to work, Taskmaster needs your Perplexity API key. You must put this key in your end file at the root of your project. Do not put it in your mcp.json file. If you put it in your mcp.json, Taskmaster will not find it and will silently fail, falling back to your standard AI model. You will think you are doing research, but you will not be. Put the key in .env and it will work perfectly. Our research request with the recommended Sonar Pro model typically costs about 1-2 cents. It may be more when researching tasks in bulk, but you won't go broke. For even deeper research, there is a deep research model, but it costs more and will likely take more time to complete. I'm adding this after testing this on my large work codebase. I had Claude expand subtasks using Sonar Pro. The results were so hallucinated that Claude itself noticed that and offered to fix them. My assumption is that Perplexity doesn't get the full project file context that Claude Code does, so be careful. Use Perplexity for external, up-to-date knowledge. But for tasks tied to your internal code, it will lack context and can produce the wrong output. So, how does this look in a day-to-day workflow? This is how I use Claude Code to do the work for me. I start by asking what's the next task. Claude runs Taskmaster next. I review the task. Claude runs Taskmaster show 5. Next, I tell Claude, please expand this task. Use research. After I review the subtasks, I decide how to delegate. If the subtasks are simple, I'll just ask Claude to implement task 5, handling all subtasks at once. If they seem more chunky or complex, I'll work one by one. I'll ask please implement 5.1, then clear the context and ask for 5.2. Or for a really complex subtask, I'll ask it to spin subagent with a fresh context window to focus just on that one. Finally, if I'm reviewing the work and see that the implementation isn't quite right, I use it as a log. I tell Claude, update subtask 5.2. The implementation needs to be course corrected. The auth middleware should be refactored first. This way, I am not just a developer, but an architect. I am guiding the AI, letting it handle the implementation and using the task list as our shared source of truth and the log of all decisions. This next tip is for all my fellow MCP users. Have you ever noticed that sometimes your AI assistant feels a bit slow or context window fills up fast? By default, the Taskmaster MCP server loads all 36 of its tools into your context. This is great for features, but bad for performance. It uses over 20,000 tokens before you even type a word. The advanced solution is to tell Taskmaster which tools you need. You can do this by setting an environment variable called TaskmasterTools. You can set this in your .env file or better in your MCP configuration. All is the default, 36 tools. Standard loads 15 common tools, saving 15% of the tokens. Core or lean loads only 7 essential tools for daily work, like get tasks, next task, and update subtask. This saves you 70% of the token cost. For my daily work, I set my Taskmaster tools to core. This keeps my context window clean, my responses fast, and saves those precious tokens for my code. And this problem isn't just Taskmaster. Other popular MCPs like the ones for Chrome DevTools or Playwright can load immense number of tools. If you're using Claude Code, you can type /context command to see exactly how much of your prompt is pre-filled with tools. My advice, load these heavy MCP tools only on demand when you need them, and God forbid you install them globally. That would be a permanent performance hit on every single prompt. Finally, let's talk about reality. Projects never go perfectly to plan. Requirements change. Estimates are wrong. Taskmaster is built for this. You don't need to delete your tasks and start over. You just correct the course. Scenario 1. A big change. The plan was REST, but now it's GraphQL. Just tell Claude, we're switching to GraphQL. Update all tasks from 5 onwards to reflect this. Claude will run Taskmaster update --from5--prompt--research. The AI will rewrite all future tasks for you. Scenario 2. A task is more complex than you thought. You start task 3 and realize it's a monster. Tell Claude, this task is way more complex than I thought. It also needs to handle multi-tenancy. Claude will run Taskmaster scope up --id3, strength equal heavy. The AI will reevaluate the task, update its description, and suggest more subtasks. Scenario 3. The subtasks are wrong. You expanded the task, but the subtasks are not right. Tell Claude, clear the subtasks for task 5 and re-expand it, but this time, focus on security and testing. Claude will run Taskmaster clear subtasks --id5 and then Taskmaster expand --id5--force --prompt. You can add or remove dependencies, move tasks between parents, or change a subtask into a full task. The system is flexible. Remember, the task list is not a stone tablet. It's a living document. Use these commands to make it reflect the reality of your project. There is even more to explore, like running multiple AI agents in parallel to work on non-conflicting tasks. But the workflows we covered today, tasks for organization, research for quality, and course correction for flexibility, are the core of the advanced methodology. This is how I am managing my projects now. It's organized, it's flexible, and it produces high-quality, well-researched code. This is the real power of Taskmaster AI. It's not just a to-do list, it's a complete AI-native development system. That's all for today. I hope this deep dive was helpful. Let me know in the comments how you are using Taskmaster and what you'd like to see next. I know many of you are interested in more material on coding an application from a bare idea, from scratch. I hear you, and I'll drop a video about it soon. I'm creating this video under severe circumstances for you, and I'd really appreciate if you like and subscribe. And most importantly, don't forget to delight your cat with a nice white high-quality Apple bag. Until next time.